Guys, gals, my name is Luke. Welcome to this episode of the Outdoor Gear Review. For the most part of the summer, I've been testing out the ORU Bay ST Foldable Kayak. Take a look at this thing. It's very unusual in its design. It is what they refer to as an origami kayak. It's very lightweight, roughly 28 pounds. You can easily pick it up and transport this thing anywhere you want to. Check this out. 28 pounds. When was the last time that you saw somebody do that with a kayak? Now with this product, there's a lot of pros, but also there are some cons. With that being said, let's get to the review now. When it comes to my reviews, I like to start with stats first, so let the trend continue. When it comes to weight, as mentioned, 28 pounds. When it comes to the dimensions, when it's fully set up, as you see here, you are looking at 12 feet long and 25 inches wide. This has a weight capacity of 300 pounds. It is a one-seater, and there is plenty of room for your gear, which I will talk about a little bit further into the review. This kayak is made in the United States, which does contribute to the high price tag, which we will come back to also in just a minute. Moving on with the stats, let's talk about the materials. What you are looking at here is essentially double-walled plastic, 5mm, and it has been rated for 20,000 folds. It features a 10-year UV treatment, and if you purchase this kayak, it does come with a 1-year warranty. Now lastly, when it comes to the stats, let's talk about its folded up compressed size. When it's folded up, you're looking at 33 inches by 12 inches by 29 inches. Considering that this is a kayak, those dimensions are very impressive. The company states that this is similar to a suitcase, well, kind of. In truth, it would be the largest suitcase you have ever seen, but when it's all folded up, it's not bad by any means. Moving on with this review, we should talk about who the Bay ST kayak is for. Who is it meant for? Who is it right for? Because of the lightweight nature of this kayak, I would recommend it for essentially calm, smooth water. This is rated for class 1, class 2 rapids. In my opinion, class 2 is pushing it a little bit for this kayak. When it comes to being influenced by the surroundings, by the environment, because it's so lightweight, it is easily done so. It's easily influenced. Now, it tracks very well for being such a light boat. It turns very well for being such a light boat. But again, when it comes to those waves, they will influence you greatly. Now, personally, I would say class A, class 1. Just in case you don't know, class A is essentially lake water. Very calm, glass surface. Class 1, this is very easy, smooth water, light ripples, clear passages, not much to worry about in terms of rocks, debris, and so on. Class 2 is for moderate conditions, and we're talking about medium, quick moving water, regular waves, with clear open passages between rocks and ledges. Class 2 requires some maneuvering, and with that being stated, again folks, Class 2, in my opinion, really is pushing this boat to its limits. It is made for calm water, you know, riding the river, playing in the lake. I would not really take this out on any true rapids. When it comes to tracking, this boat performs very well, much better than I expected, especially for being such a lightweight boat. Now, is it the world's best tracker? No. When you paddle, you will have to correct it on the opposite side. Of course, depending on how fast and how much strength that you are using. Now, with that being said, I've used much heavier boats that have tracked worse than this one. In my opinion, this one tracks pretty darn well, considering that it's only 28 pounds. If you are accustomed to a heavier boat that tracks very well, you may not like this because, again, it is lightweight and it is easily influenced by your actions and the surrounding environment. When it comes to turning, it's not bad at all. I wouldn't say that it turns on a dime, and for most people, you don't want a kayak that turns on a dime. Essentially, what happens is that you paddle and you push the boat this way. Paddle, push it that way. There's a time and a place. If you're doing strong rapids, you want a boat like that. Otherwise, you don't. You want a boat that takes some work to actually get it to turn. This one takes a little bit of work. It's not bad. It's essentially what you would want in a kayak for lake water, calm water, river water, and so on. When it comes to stability, it's not bad at all. I've had no issues with tipping with this boat. At no point in time did I feel like I was going to tip because it's so lightweight. The first time that you get inside of this, if you're not an experienced kayaker, you're going to feel a little topsy-turvy. The important thing is don't overreact. It really does take quite a bit to flip a kayak. It's going to take quite a bit to flip this. In truth, it's all about balance. Using your core a little bit, paddling at the same time, you'll get it figured out. But all in all, it's a very stable kayak. When it comes to max speed of this boat, it really is not built for speed. The fastest that I've got this up to is probably about 5 miles an hour, something like that. And that's just all out paddling as hard as I can. It's not a sustainable speed. Because it's so lightweight though, it does get up and move fairly well. It reacts to the amount of pressure that you're exerting in the water. Let's take a second here and let's talk about ease of use when it comes to unfolding and setting up this kayak. This does take some work. It does take some time. You will have to learn how to put together this kayak. Now, in my opinion, for me specifically, it's very easy. Once you get the steps down, you can do this in 5 minutes. I'm at the point where 5 minutes, I can have this done, maybe even a little bit faster if I hurry. It all makes sense in the end. The steps are just 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, blah, blah, blah. With that being said, not everyone is the same when it comes to figuring things out and how to put things together. I have spoken to people who have used these, who own these. It could still take them like 40 minutes to put this together. Again, I could do it in 5, but for them, for some people, it takes longer. How long will it take you to put it together? I have no idea. Everybody's different. Some people will find this incredibly complicated. Some people will find this very, very easy. With any product that you're considering purchasing, you need to ask yourself, is it a good fit for you? And with this kayak, that's a question. Is it a good fit for you? Are you able to put things together, take things apart easily? If you have issues with that, this is not a product that I recommend. So yes, in my opinion, it is very easy to set up. It's even easier to break down, to fold it up. And when you go to store it, it takes up a small amount of space. Something has to be mentioned here. Just because this kayak folds down to a small size does not mean that it is right for you if you're limited on space. I will tell you why in just a moment. Moving on with the pros, it is impressive when it comes to size. You can essentially fold this up and store it just about anywhere. Storing is a huge plus when it comes to this kayak. You could store it inside, outside. You could shove it in the closet if your closet is big enough. You could shove it under your bed if you have the space. You can essentially store this anywhere. And because this folds up so small, you could fit this in any vehicle. Maybe you do not have a truck. Maybe you don't have an SUV. You don't have to worry about that. You can stick this inside of your car, you can put it inside the trunk, and so on. When it comes to cleaning this kayak, this is a pro and also a con. Let's talk about the pro first. You can easily unfold this, wipe it out, drain the water, and so on. Now, I should say you can drain the water that's gathered on the inside of the kayak easily, essentially where you sit. You can dump that out, wipe it out, great. The con side is that water will actually gather between the double layers of plastic. And this presents a problem. For some people, a serious problem. I will come back to this in just a moment. When it comes to seating, the padding and whatnot, this is the bare minimum. After roughly an hour and a half, my butt, my back start getting sore. If you're going out for a long duration, you will need to bring some additional cushion, some pads, maybe a towel or two. That will help a lot. Now, the good thing is everything here is adjustable. You can adjust the back. You can also adjust the footrest on the inside so you can get the right fit for you. When it comes to storing gear inside of this kayak, you can fit quite a bit. You could fit a lot of gear here in the front and quite a bit in the back as well. Lastly, when it comes to the durability of this double-walled plastic, I have to say that I'm impressed with it. With all of my testing so far, I've had no issues. I've beached this thing many times. It essentially hasn't shown anywhere from doing that. No scrapes or anything from the rocks. Now, if you try hard enough, if you plow into a rock big enough, you can scratch this. You could probably tear a hole in it as well. I would not recommend this for situations where there's going to be lots of sharp rocks and whatnot. You have to remember what this material is. It is not as strong, in my opinion, as a hard shell kayak, but it's definitely stronger than an inflatable. Now that we have the pros out of the way, let's talk about cons, because there are some real world cons which we need to address. First off, depending on what type of kayak that you're coming from to this, you may not like the way that it handles. It is, again, very lightweight, so you may not like the way that a lightweight kayak handles. That so much isn't a con for this specific kayak, but the general nature of this kayak. As I was discussing before, this boat is easy to clean, but at the same time, this requires a substantial amount of dry time. It's not just the water that gets on the inside of the boat, but water will actually gather between those layers of plastic and will essentially fill up those channels. So when you get done kayaking, you need to keep this in mind. You have to set this thing up and let that water drain out. Otherwise, you could have a huge mess inside of your house. This is a big problem for some people. Those people who are limited on space, who are looking for a very small kayak, may not have the space outdoors to set up this kayak and to let that water drain. It will take days for that water to exit this boat. And that's because there are holes that surround this double wall material all the way around here. And there's nothing you can do to essentially stop this boat from gathering water. If you are limited on space and also areas where you can store this thing outside for a couple of days to let that water drain, this is not the right kayak for you. Moving on, because of the design of this kayak and the locking channels on the front and on the back, water can come inside of your kayak. It will certainly be more water than your typical hard-shelled kayak because it's enclosed. Because water can splash up and essentially go between where the plastic pieces meet. Because of that, you will want to make sure that all of your gear is in dry bags. Every single bit of it has to be in a dry bag because water will get inside the cockpit area of the boat. Another con that I have to mention is somewhat funny, somewhat humorous, but this thing gets a lot of attention. It really does. Everywhere I've gone to set this up, and I've used this roughly 25 times so far this summer, people have talked to me about it. Depending on the type of person you are, you may not like people coming up to you, starting conversations, and so on. And this is something that will get some attention. Every single time I've set this up, people have come by, talked to me. Luckily, I do not mind talking to people all that much, but you may not. Now, moving on to real cons, we have to talk about quality. This is an issue that has plagued this company since their inception. Hopefully things have improved, but I cannot comment on that. There are plenty of reports of people having issues with their foldable kayaks from this company, and some people have had those issues addressed, and there are reports of other people who have not. Have I had any issues with this kayak? Yes, I have, unfortunately. One of the bulkhead channels has ripped off. Now, this is a used kayak. The PR company sent this to me to review. It's a used kayak. Now, the thing is, the channel that ripped off had ripped off previously and had been repaired and then ripped off again. So yes, that is an issue. I was told that I can easily fix this with some epoxy, but the thing is, folks, $1,600 for a kayak. That's a lot of money. For $1,600, I don't want to be using epoxy on it. I shouldn't have to be fixing it. Now, when it comes to the issues that you can have with a kayak, most likely that is the issue that you're going to have. Those channels do seem to be weak. They can tear off, as I've experienced. Those are, for the most part, the greatest level of concern and issues that I've seen online. I have been told that the company has sorted all of this out, but it is something that you need to be aware of. I have to talk about the warranty. It's a one-year warranty compared to other kayak companies out there. That's pretty good. But we're still talking about $1,600. I would like to see a limited lifetime warranty for this kayak. If a user slams their kayak into a rock and tears a big hole in it, it's their fault. If the channel rips off, I want the company to fix it on their dime. What do you all think about that? Am I right or am I wrong? Comment down below. That really does lead us to the final con, the final topic of discussion when it comes to this review. Cost. $1,600 is very, very expensive. For most people, this is out of the realm of possibility. My first car didn't cost $1,600. There are other companies out there that make foldable kayaks, and they are much, much less expensive. In fact, the closest competitor offers a foldable kayak, which runs $350. This is $1,600. If you're limited on space, you can always consider an inflatable kayak, and those run less than $100. Am I a huge fan of inflatable kayaks? No, not really. If you're interested in a cheap hardshell kayak, you could find those $300, $450, $500, something like that. Of course, you can find them used all the time. My personal kayak, which is an Emotion kayak, you guys have seen this numerous times, it cost me like $350 from Amazon, and they shipped it to my house for free. I've had it for almost 10 years and I've never had a single issue with that kayak. Is it the greatest kayak ever? No, but it costs $350 and it's never let me down. There are so many things that you need to think about when it comes to this specific kayak. And here with the Outdoor Gear Review, it's not my place to tell you if you should buy something or if you shouldn't. I simply pass on my thoughts, my experiences of a product, and you're free to make up your own mind. And that is essentially what I'm going to do here. Hopefully with this review, I've given you plenty to think about. And because with this product, there's a lot here to think about. Does this work for you? If you're limited on space, it may work for you. But do you have the space outside to set this up and to let it drain? This is not something you can set up and drain in your bathtub. It has to be outside. Quality is a concern. Hopefully that has truly been addressed. I cannot comment on that. All in all, I do like this product. And the truth is, my family does as well. My son has used it. He likes this kayak. Again, it really does work well as a beginner's kayak. But is it worth $1,600? Is it? It could be for you, but then again, you may feel that this is just simply too much. Ultimately, with the Bay ST, this solves many problems that people face when it comes to owning a kayak, but it doesn't solve all of them. It doesn't solve all of them, and it's also expensive. With that being said, everyone, that's my review and I'm sticking to it. What do you all think about the Bay ST foldable kayak? This is certainly an interesting product. Will it work well with you? Only you can decide. If you have any questions, make sure to email me. Make sure to comment down below. Share your thoughts about this kayak. If you have experiences with this kayak, share those, please. Everyone, take care, strength and honor. I'll see you guys around.